It is the wedding the world is talking about, has been talking about for a long time, too. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle all set to walk down the aisle this weekend. So every Wednesday at 4 for the past, like, month here, we have been sharing royal wedding-themed books. Joining us to talk about the last one of these, it's the last chapter in this. It's a book called Royal Treatment, and Gwen Reyes, our book critic from freshfiction.com, is here to break this one down. You know, we've covered a lot of different royalish books here in the past couple of weeks.
We have. You know, like last week we talked about an actual biography, nonfiction, but this week, in respect for 50 Shades of Grey, which is out on Blu-ray and DVD, we have a new sexy read for anyone who is really into the royal wedding, but also might be a little more into what happens after the royal wedding.
Uh-huh. You are steaming things up with this one, huh?
So I love this book because it's so interesting, because we've got the combination of an international royal person who is a prince, who has been actually dethroned, even though he's a twin, because he was held captive by some extremists, and the country doesn't trust him anymore. It's very Homeland-esque in that way, so they remove him from his duties. He's now a playboy. He doesn't know what he's doing with his life. He's very aimless, because all he's been trained for his whole time has been to be king of this principality.
And so he goes wild.
He goes wild, and he meets this woman who meets him toe-to-toe and is just as crazy, but also just as respectful and just as disciplined as he is. She's a young entrepreneur from America. So again, we see a lot of similarities between a British royal and an American, kind of stirring things up together.
You put some real thought into this this time. And, you know, we were talking about this, and, you know, I was reading the description of this that you sent over, and it made me want to read more.
Good.
Because I don't read much, at least books anyway. And so I saw this, and I told you that when I walked in, and you mentioned something to me that I hadn't thought of, and that is you can listen to the audiobook
version. You could listen to the audiobook version of this if you want, but I'm always a little uncomfortable with, like, these sexier books like that. Just because you never know, especially you have kids, you're going for carpool, you have it on the Bluetooth, and then everybody gets in the car and you're like, what am I doing with my life?
Slightly awkward.
Yeah, slightly awkward, but also a good conversation starter.
But this one sounds like it is a pretty quick read
once you
get into it.
It's a very quick read. It's really fun. It's the second in a series, so if you like this one, and they stand alone, so you don't have to read them together. But if you love this one, you can go back and read Royal Pain by Tracy Wolff. And also, fun fact, Tracy is a local writer. She's from Austin, Texas.
Oh, very cool. Mm-hmm. So one more reason to pick this one up.
Absolutely.
Gwen, it's been fun going through our theme weeks here.
Yes, thank you. Next week I'll have, like, black circles under my eyes because I've stayed up all weekend long for the wedding.
Well, you can tell me all about it because I don't plan to get up for that. But we'll tell you how you can watch it this weekend. We've got a lot of coverage planned here on ABC. Thanks for being with us
today,
Gwen.
Jason.